Hello, everybody. Welcome to Cigar Review TV. I'm your host, Damon Pettit. And just going to do a quick little hangout, cigar talk, a quick little second review on a cigar I've done before. It's a La Aroma de Cuba Robusto. And I believe I did this one once before. It was I think it was like my 22nd show. So just thought I wanted to go out and have a little smoke, pre-Easter smoke. Well, it doesn't matter what day it is, to be honest with you. Nicaraguan. It is, they are part of the Ashton Company. Now, the ones I've had before have not given me any problems, so we'll see how this is. Really spicy at the get-go. There are quite a few bugs around here today, sitting right around the light. So it's going to be kind of like one of those blue lights. Hope everybody's doing well. Just want to say Happy Easter. It'll probably be after Easter even when you see this, but get my one got a little bottled coffee. I felt it cold. I'm kind of thirsty and I was going to get, you know, some sort of, I don't know, tea or water. Everything has got either an unbelievable amount of sugar or the high fructose corn syrup. Wow. See a ladybug over here. I've never seen a ladybug at night. It might sound weird, but it's true. Have you ever seen a ladybug at night? Are you lost? Well, today is the 19th, I believe, of April, and it's very, very nice. Beautiful weather, of course, here. It's pretty much usual. No wind. This coffee tastes pretty good. Just the bottled stuff, not bad. Nice tasty cigar so far. Pretty, very nice draw. And pretty spice. Peppery all through the mouth right now, all the way around. So we'll see if that calms down or kicks up a little bit. I'm not exactly sure. Probably not gonna do a huge long one this time, as far as I know. I don't have my little microphone hooked up because I have this balancing on a pole type. So if there was a wind, I wouldn't be doing this at all. At least not here. But, so, probably might not be as long as the other ones. Which, sure don't break everybody's heart. I haven't really been looking at the news too much this week. The week went really fast, actually, and quite shocking how quick it can go. There's people coming up this way. I don't know what they would, if they're just taking a stroll or what it is. They turned, so that's good. Right now, it's like a very peppery cigar at the moment. Very peppery. A lot of bugs around here right now. Trying to keep my thing closed. News. They're still looking for that airplane. Well, I don't know if they're looking for that anymore, but they never found it. You see, they had that ferry that hit something and tilted over. And the captain took off. It's a real good guy, huh? Took off. It's unbelievable. But, so there's that kind of crappy news. I haven't really heard any real good news, I guess. I haven't really, like I said, been watching the news, period. So, sporting news. What is, I guess you got basketball playoff bullcrap going on. I do know that Phoenix had a chance to make it in, and they're gone, they're out of it. So I don't know exactly who is in. I actually, every now and then, listen to a little bit of sports radio, try to catch up a little bit, and didn't really do me a whole lot of good when it's only about 20 minutes worth. Smoke those bugs out of here. Pepper's calming down a little bit, which is kind of nice. I don't mind some pepper, but this, at first it was really packing a punch. Oh, man. Easter, what else? really, just trying to think if there's... I know what I wanted to do. My main form of entertainment is not usually TV. I watch some here and there. Usually with the roommates more than anything. But, let's see. Something I watch on TV that, like, if it comes on... If it comes on and I'm not in the room and I don't see it, then I don't miss it. But when it comes on, I kind of end up watching the whole thing usually, and that's I think it's called Kitchen Nightmares with Ramsay, Chef Ramsay, whatever the hell his name is. That guy's unbelievable. What he does for restaurants. And there's also a couple of shows that are on, like, the different cable channel, and I have no idea what the channel is, because my roommates usually will turn it, and it'll be on, so I have no idea what what network or anything else. I just know it's on cable. And it's the Property Brothers, who are these two guys, they're brothers. One is a real estate guy, the other guy does a lot of the makeover on the house. It's probably like a, I guess you might call him a contractor or whatever. But that's kind of a cool show. But then my main form of entertainment, I'd have to say, would be YouTube. And I try, very uncomfortable here, sorry. I try to get things that give me some knowledge. Like every now and then I'll watch some funny crap, like pranks that people play on each other or whatever. Those are kind of fun to watch, but I like to see like people like you and me just telling about a certain experience that they had doing something that has to do like the spiritual type of realm, not religious, but like I don't know, lucid dreaming and crap like that. So I find all that kind of stuff very interesting. And there's one channel on there, and I'll put a link to it in my description. And what he is, he was a detective at one point, a private detective, I believe. And he did other things and became a private detective, and then started to wanted to investigate what happens when you die type thing. And so he interviews, he's a very good interviewer, and he does a lot of really good interviews for, with just regular people that have actually died, you know, gone through their little experience, come back, and that kind of thing. So they tell about their experience with him, and then other things that go on, some psychics and stuff like that. And he just kind of interviews them, and it's very, very, very interesting. And it's like if you are not this, you know, ingrained with some religion, which usually will completely shut out any of that kind of open-mindedness, which, you know, I understand that. But so unless you're a complete devout atheist or a devout Christian or whatever, that's just not going to hear any of that, then you wouldn't want to listen to it. But if you're ever, you know, kind of wondering, kind of just, you know, think every now and then, what the hell is going to happen when I die? You know? It's kind of interesting to listen to all these people and all their experiences, and a lot of them did not believe in anything before, or they, you know, had a Christian background, or they had just a complete background of absolutely no religion or whatever. So very interesting. His name is Bob. Now I can't fucking remember it. I know how it is. His YouTube thing, channel, I believe, is called Afterlife TV. And so let me see. I'll put it in, link it up in there, and it's just very, very interesting information. Like I said, what I'll try to do through some of my reviews is also just, if there's something I'm interested in or whatever, I'll throw a link there. If it's something that I know will offend too many people, or, you know, there's a lot of weird things out there, but if there's something like that, I probably won't share it. But let's see. I don't know if I'll, I swear to God, there's so many bugs right now. I don't think you can see them. They're like these real tiny ones, and they're everywhere. We're almost there. Almost there. Almost there. Shit. Really? Odd, considering usually if you look through your history in YouTube, it'll pop right up. Oh, there we go. Yeah, Afterlife TV. And his name is... Fuck. Bob. It's again. Okay. Bob Olson. That's his name. And it looks like this. So, that's just a little thing in case any of you all are interested in that, passing that on. I like listening to different people like that, as long as there's not like a profit-driven thing. It's not this big marketing ploy of any kind. And I understand if, you know, psychics and different things like that will make some money, which they should, because they're being paid as a communicator, just like we pay Verizon so we can communicate with each other on a phone. Now, that's if you believe any of this shit, that's for, and I happen to. So let's say, you know, great-grandpa Tuttle died and you were really close with him, and so you want to do talk with him, and you can, and you believe that and all that, and you use a psychic, one of these, a medium, to hopefully be able to communicate with them if it all works out. So, I'm just saying, what I was getting to with that is, you know, I don't just sit there and believe everybody. There are different points where people use spiritual stuff, religious stuff, whatever it is, to make money, and that's all it is. And that I don't like, whatever it is. I don't care if it's whatever it is, if they're completely destroying whatever it is, just to get, because it's only money driven, then for me, it doesn't, that just doesn't ring true. Should be back on the bike. Oh my god, sorry. Thinking this week. I've been staying off of it for a while, trying to have some issues like with some back and all this muscle stuff going on. But what it kind of boiled down to is a never stretch. And so now I've been stretching every day, close to like about anywhere from 15 to 30 minutes a day. It's much better. So it seems to be pretty important. You'd think I would know that. And I kind of did. It's just, it's never been my favorite thing. I remember in football, when you know, go out there, you're getting ready to do some stuff, but you have to do all your stretches first. I hated that. I'd always end up sweating more doing that than anything. It was just very uncomfortable. Never liked it. But there's a reason for it. See, this cigar. I've had this cigar a few times. I gotta stand up and shake some bugs off. Hold on. It's just a little too freaky. I've had the cigar a few times now, and each time has been a decent cigar experience. It's not like, this isn't like one of my favorite cigars. It's not a go-to cigar, but it's a cigar that I have, when I've smoked it, I've enjoyed it decently. It's a relatively very inexpensive cigar. It's $5.50, and that's where I am here. And that's a decent price for a Robusto size cigar, decent made cigar. Well, I'm glad I got iced coffee this time, or cold coffee. Sometimes it just tastes better. It goes well with the cigar. Pretty damn decent. Coming up a couple months, few months, what is it? May, June, July. So 3 whole months. And then right at the end of July, do my vacation, go out to Colorado. So I'm looking forward to that. Trying to make some extra money. That way I can think about buying a horse when I'm out there. I'm joking. What am I going to do with a horse? It would probably come out here and die. But I hope everybody is staying safe, staying happy. Just one thing. Another thing. For those of you who happen to do some cycling or riding a bike, even a motorcycle, but definitely bike, just be careful. When I ride my bike, I try to stay as much off the street as I can, especially out here in Phoenix. Not exactly a safe place to be biking, at least on the streets anyway. It's dangerous enough actually driving your car out here. So I'm just saying, be safe. Keep seeing posts of people getting hit, and it just blows me away how other people will hit somebody and drive off, you know, if it's an accident or whatever. I begin to think that they're not accidents. I probably have already recommended to go ahead and get the cigar. If you just have try a little cigars here and there, that kind of thing, and you're looking for something that's not really expensive, maybe you want a couple to play poker with or go golfing or whatever, decent cigar, not too bad. Like I said, it's not like my favorite. It's just a cigar that I ended up picking up every now and then, and I've never had any problems with them. So consistency is good. I'll link up my other one as well. That I think it's show 22, something like that. Nicaraguan cigar. Well, I think that's gonna be about it. Can't really trying to think if there's anything else that's been going on. Not really. I hope everybody has a fantastic Easter, a safe Easter, and week, and month, day, whatever it is, whenever you're watching this. Hope it finds you in good spirits, and having a nice cigar. My hand just got dripped on by something. I don't see anything around, so there's a tree up here, but I don't see a bird, so let's hope. Well, my friends, have a great one. Have a fantastic day, night, whatever. And see if I can get this baby put up maybe today, so it'll be up all day tomorrow, which is Easter. And thank you for watching. I really do appreciate any time anybody watches and sits through the whole thing. Feel free to comment. Let me know if there's anything you want me to talk about, or cigar news, that kind of thing. If you want to hear more like cigar news, anything like that, I'll delve into that a lot more, and you know, start reading quite a bit more about different things that are going on in the cigar industry, which only kind of makes sense. But I also like to talk about other shit too, so it won't just be that. So I'm gonna go and walk around a little bit and see if I can get away from these bugs. You have a fantastic day. Thank you again for watching. I'll be seeing you, and well, you'll be seeing me, and I'll be smoking with you again very soon. Take care.